Hello, and welcome to our video. Today, we'll be configuring our indoor smart trainer with the Rider 750. In this video, we will go through connecting our smart trainer, modifying trainer settings, adjusting resistance levels and desired wattage, as well as following a workout and virtual ride. Before we get started, ensure you've already downloaded the Brighton Active app from the iOS Marketplace or Google Play Store and created your Brighton Active account. So, without further ado, let's get started. We will begin by mounting the Rider 750 on our smart trainer setup. Then, we'll press the power button on the left side of the device to boot up. Once booted, from the home screen, ensure that you select the right bike profile for your smart trainer. In this video, we have already created a profile named Trainer that we'll use specifically for this. Next, open the Courses menu and select Smart Trainer. Since we have not yet connected a smart trainer, we will press the green plus key to add one. Your trainer, if plugged in and powered on, should automatically appear. To connect, simply press on the sensor and it'll connect to your smart trainer. Alternatively, if your sensor does not appear, you can turn your pedals to awaken it. Once added, the Smart Trainer menu will populate with new options. To begin, we'll start by configuring trainer settings. Here you can see more information about the device and its various settings. You can see the sensor details, including type of connection and ID. After that, we'll then modify the trainer's resistance level on the list. So after selecting resistance, you can use the plus or minus keys to increase or decrease resistance. When you've selected the desired level, press start. This will allow the modifiable resistance field to appear on your meter page. You can adjust the level during your training by pressing the plus or minus keys on the meter page. Additionally, by pressing the page button, you can cycle through your other data pages on your meter page. Okay, to return to the main menu, simply swipe up from the meter page. From here, we will return back to the Smart Trainer menu under Courses, and this time select Target Power. To begin, press on the number and enter your desired wattage. Once you've confirmed your selection, press OK and then Start. Again, the power will appear on your meter page. During your training, you can use the plus or minus key to increase or decrease the desired wattage. Additionally, you can press anywhere on the screen to view your connectivity in the Quick Sensor menu. So, swiping up again and returning to the main menu, we will again go to the Smart Trainer menu by pressing Course and Smart Trainer. And from the list, we will then select Workout, which allows you to follow custom workouts that you have synced from the Brighton Active app. You can find more information on how to sync workouts in the description below. So, from the options on the screen, we'll choose My Workout, and once selected, you'll be brought to an overview of the whole workout. This will give you specific information on each step of the workout you've created. To begin, press Start, and while following the workout, the screen will provide prompts when you are over or under the requirements for each part. Please be sure to pay attention to the notifications, which are both audio and color, that'll help you keep on track with your workout. When finished, you can exit the workout and return to the meter page, followed by the home screen. We'll then return to the Smart Trainer menu again under Course, and this time select Virtual Ride. If you have already downloaded a virtual ride to your Rider 750, it will appear here. For more information on how to do this, please see the link in the description below. After a moment, the Rider 750 will display an overview of the virtual ride along with a detailed summary. To begin, press start, and the ride will begin. In the virtual ride, as you pedal, you will progress through the course with this trainer's resistance increasing or decreasing depending on your location in the route. After you finish riding, press the red X and confirm that you would like to end the virtual ride. Then return back to the main menu. That's all for today's video. Thank you all for watching, and if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. Be sure to like, subscribe, and press the bell icon to get updates on our latest videos.